If you need the money, you're talking to Hashem, you're telling Hashem, I need my parnasa. The reason that you need parnasa, it's not the reason to go to work in a certain store. If you need to work, it doesn't mean that you're going to get the money from that work. A person can work all of his life and not to find the parnasa that he needs. He's working from 5 in the morning until 8, 10 at night, every day. He is a cab driver, and he has debts more than you can imagine. How can it be? Because HaKadosh Baruch Hu is pushing him. HaKadosh Baruch Hu is making this reality for him, that he's going to wake up. And for us, Avrechim, people learning in the yeshiva, from the morning until the evening, we're just learning and davening and doing mitzvot, and in the end, we don't have debts for no one. And we have apartments, and how can it be? Because Hashem wants it to happen. So you have hard times, sometimes you're falling from the faith, but the main thing that we're trying to do is to daven and to daven and to ask for Hashem Yitbarach. Rabbi Akiva, when he wanted to be a Talmid Chacham, the first thing that he done, he went to the yeshiva. He tried to learn Torah, he couldn't make it. He was 40 years old. First day, when he was 40, he tried to learn letter Aleph, letter Bet, Kamatz Aleph, A, Kamatz Bet, Ba. He tried to learn Chumash, he tried to learn how to read. He was just in the beginning, and he couldn't. So what he done? He went out from the yeshiva to the fields where the rivers are, the stream of the water, and he was crying to Hashem Yitbarach. And then HaKadosh Baruch Hu showed him, after he was crying, like we said, when you're davening, when you're making the itbodedut, HaKadosh Baruch Hu is sending you the message, the tzaddik is with you. And after he was crying, he saw that the water are dropping on that stone. And then he understood that it's not the power of the water that is carving and making a hole in the stone, just the fact that they're coming all of the time, tamid, how you say tamid, usually,
constantly.
This is the fact that makes the hole in the stone, not the power. So, this was Rabbi Akiva. In the Gemara, they're asking what the person should do if he's willing to achieve wisdom, to learn Torah. He needs to do what Rabbi Akiva done. What Rabbi Akiva done? Ask from the one that have the wisdom. You need to try to learn also. But also Torah Kedoshah, you can't learn. Open this book. You can never achieve from that book nothing if HaKadosh Baruch Hu doesn't want you to achieve. You understand? A lot of people sitting and learning Likutei Moharan, learning, they can know it by heart, and they can't understand what there is inside of the Likutei Moharan. They can never understand. Why? Because they doesn't have the improvement from HaKadosh Baruch Hu to learn Torah now. Their time is also important that they are in the Torah Kedoshah, but they still doesn't have the privilege to take out all of the diamonds that there is inside. And we still doesn't have the privilege to learn more than we are learning. Everyone have a certain, and not in this class, not everyone learning the same. I'm saying the same words, but you can learn something, you can learn something else, you can learn something else, and maybe one of you, your limud is a lot higher. Why? Because you have more prayers on the limud. You're davening to Hashem. You know that you're nothing. You're asking on your limud. You're telling Hashem, please, teach me, give me the advice. I want to learn Torah. It's just a temporary world, that in this world, in this period of time, we have a mission. What's the mission? The mission is only not to forget the Creator, to remember that it's all Him, never to fall in the trap of all of those coverings, of all of those husks.